Hi, I'm Eric Summerer, and here's what's coming from the Dice Tower this week.
Hey! It's time for another week. Another week full of board games, another week full of board game news, which of course you can find at gamesalutenews.com, or you can check out our three times a week podcast from Rima Gibson, where he talks about all the board game news. But folks, tons of exciting things, always. Let's go. First, we'll start in the board gaming world. Fantasy Flight has announced a ton of new stuff. Interestingly enough, they announced a Hobbit expansion for their Lord of the Rings card game, and then they also announced a Hobbit card game designed by Martin Wallace. Two different things, and X-Wing. X-Wing is in stores, so go out. Well, it's being sold out really quickly everywhere I can see, so go out and get it if you're interested in it, or check out the new ships they have coming. Asmodee has a whole pile of things coming out in October, so be on the lookout for those. The new expansion for Eclipse, Dixit Jinx, and Sherlock Holmes Consulting Detective. I haven't been able to figure out yet if this is a reprint of the original game, but still, either way, Sherlock Holmes games can't be anything but good. A couple other things, of course, War of the Rings, their Ares Games is releasing a promo called Treebeard, which is pretty neat. I mean, you can actually use him to rally the Ents. Looks pretty neat to have that. WizKids has announced a new expansion for Mage Knight, which people have been looking forward to. Allows you to play with five players, which seems a bit insane, but hey, more cards and more things is always very interesting. And finally, Victory Point Games has decided to start producing boxed games. Hey. You know, all these companies always say, oh, we like to produce cheap games, we like to produce low quality games. Every single one of those companies that has said that they would do that has eventually upgraded. I'm telling you, it's just gonna keep happening. Well, let's take a look at some reviews that are coming out this week. Ryan will be taking a look at Scripts and Scribes, the dice game. He'll also be taking a look at a new game that I haven't heard of yet called Noblemen. And finally, he'll be taking a look at the much, you know, woohoo, we wanted to see the Glory of the Rome Black Box Edition, which really looks boring, but maybe it's not. And then I'll be reviewing a couple party games, Furt and the Magic Feather. We'll be taking a look at Puzzle Strike 3rd Edition. I think they're going to win the award for having most editions in the shortest amount of time. But also, while we look at this 3rd Edition, we'll be looking at the Companion Set, which is kind of the same thing, a playable standalone expansion, Puzzle Strike Shadows. I'll be also taking a look at Ark the Card Game. There's five different factions. It's kind of a deck building game, except it's not collectible. We have Battle Beyond Space, which is a very light battle in space game. I guess the title told you all that. Star Trek Catan, where we boldly look at a new version of Catan. Colorio, an abstract strategy color game. Urbania, which is a new game which really was kind of a surprise to me at how interesting and entertaining it was. We'll take a look at that. Jump the Shark, a storytelling game. The title is descriptive. And a couple new expansions for Summoner Wars. We have Seligulus Precision and Beller's Retribution. I never can remember what these titles mean or say, but basically some more factions for the mercenaries and for the rams, and you'll have to see. And then I'll be taking a look at the new version of the Resistance and the angelic game Ragami, or Ragami. I'm not sure how it's pronounced. It does look a little bit like a spaghetti sauce. And finally, the Dice Tower Network itself. Dice Tower Network has a lot of great podcasts, and I really encourage you to check them out, enough to fill your whole week where you can listen to something every day and more. On Board Games, number 90 has come out, where they talk about decisions. They also review several games, including Descent 2.0 and Star Trek Catan. D6 Generation has released episode 111, in which they give a very detailed review of the new game Spartacus, and they also talk about a lot of fun things they did and saw at Gen Con 2012. Flip the Table, number 11, where they play games that you don't have to, and they take a look at Nightmare Atmosphere. And Plaid Hat, number 61, talks about business relationships and how they work with other companies and find and get in touch with businesses. Shut Up and Sit Down, Season 2, Episode 5. It's hard to explain what they do in each episode. You have to go watch them. But then this one, they do review Mundus Novus, Kingdom Builder, and more, including a very special TV special.
The Dice Tower number 273 will be released tomorrow, in which we'll be talking about themes that just turn off a game for us. And we also review a few games, City of Horror and Pirates of the Spanish Main. And The Rant is back. And finally, we've added a new podcast to the Dice Tower Network. This is another video show called The Gamer's Atlas. This is done by the cartographer, and I've always enjoyed watching his reviews. They're entertaining and interesting at the same time. So go check those out. Lots of things to see and do. Of course, you can find out all this at thedicetowernetwork.com. And you can always support the show if you like at dicetower.com. Speaking of which, go vote in the People's Choice Top 100 of all time. It's coming soon. And you have about a week or so left to vote in that. I think we're up to 700 plus voters now. I need 300 more. Come on, go vote for your 20 favorite games of all time. The Top 100 is coming soon. Also, you can check out thedicetower.com for all sorts of things, including Dice Tower Convention, coming soon.
Find all this and more at dicetower.com. See you soon.